Eyewitness was rolling his camera in the moments leading up to the shootout in Roswell that killed the gunman and injured a state police officer. Only Action 7 News has the home video taken from a car that was following that chase. Action 7 News reporter Laura Terrain joins us now live from State Police Headquarters in Albuquerque.
And the man who sent us that video said he didn't really understand what he was witnessing for the first few minutes. The cars in front of him were moving so slowly that he thought maybe one of them was breaking down, not that a violent shootout was about to occur.
Okay, we're going in a slow speed chase. We got traffic blocked off on both sides of the road.
James Cupp says this was unlike anything he's ever experienced, being in the thick of a 4-mile police chase, only with the getaway car moving at a snail's pace.
For some reason, this guy wouldn't go any faster than 5 miles an hour.
Seen from Sky 7, police say this green Jaguar was driven by convicted felon Christoval Quintana. Before the shootout began, Cupp says police were trying everything to stop him.
The guy won't pull over. They've already pulled out spike strips.
When Quintana finally did stop, police say he opened fire, but Cupp has a different version of the story. He believes police coming from the other direction blocked off Quintana's car, and it was an officer who walked up to the passenger side who fired the first shot.
He just casually walked up, and he walks right up to the side window and stood there not even a split second. And the next thing you know, he just unloads his gun into the side window.
Cupp says even after that, the car kept inching along, and then
all of a sudden, everybody just started unloading their guns.
Quintana later died from his injuries. A state police sergeant was also wounded and is recovering from his. Now, when I spoke to state police tonight and told them about Cupp's version of events, they maintained that Quintana fired the first shot, though they did say that this case is under investigation. Live from State Police Headquarters in Northeast Albuquerque, Laura Terrain, KOAT, Action 7 News.
We know the name of the sergeant who was shot, but investigators have asked us not to release it because they still need to interview him.